You've presented to the people about DNA here. They can see those letters going up the spine there, and they want to know, okay, what is this code? What does it do? Why is it so important?
The information encoded along the spine of the DNA molecule directs the construction of proteins and protein machines. And proteins are the toolbox of the cell. They do all the important jobs. Just as in a toolbox, you've got a hammer, a saw, a plane, and each one of those tools can perform a function partially in virtue of the specific shape it has. The same thing is true of proteins, that they perform different jobs in the cell based on their three-dimensional structure. But what the DNA does is it provides the instructions for a whole complicated assembly machinery for building those proteins. It's a little bit like what goes on at the Boeing plant up in Seattle where I live, where the engineers use a technology called CAD-CAM, computer-assisted design and manufacturing, where they're actually, they will choose design parameters. Those parameters will be digitized, literally codified in digital code. That information will then be transmitted down a wire, and it will tell some machinery where to, for example, put the rivets on an airplane wing or whatever the mechanical part is. In other words, in our manufacturing technology today, we use digital code to make mechanical parts. Turns out the exact same thing is happening inside the cell. The digital code is stored on the DNA, and the mechanical parts are the proteins. And each one of them does a job in virtue of its three-dimensional shape, just like the tools in your toolbox. You can't hammer with a saw because it's got the wrong shape and composition. Same thing is true in the cell. The shapes of the proteins determine the jobs that they do. And there are lots of intricate shapes. We've got some on the screen to my right. But
how many different proteins are there?
Well, there's thousands of different proteins inside cells, and each one of them has a very specific task that it performs, which is what keeps the cell alive. But the shape is critical. It allows the protein to do its job. On the next slide here, we have a protein that is involved in an enzymatic reaction. It's actually breaking apart a two-part sugar. At the top of the screen, you see a little sugar that looks like a barbell. And you see how it nestles into a perfect shaped groove for the two parts of that barbell. And that hand and glove fit allows the enzyme to catalyze a breaking apart reaction that wouldn't happen without it. So it's, again and again, what you have is what's called specificity or specificity of fit. It's like hand and glove, and it's that beautiful, intricate, three-dimensional shape of the protein that allows it to fit just right to do the job that it's designed to do.
This has been an ATRI production.